Good morning, everybody. Amputee Me, Vicki here. I hope you're all having a wonderful day, and thank you for joining me on my channel today. Come have a little talk with me. I am a right above knee amputee after having my leg amputated twice. And today while I'm putting on my leg, I'm going to go over a couple things that has really been bothering me. All right, we live in this great country. I'm going to be careful here what I say so that YouTube doesn't pull my video, but I believe we live in a great country, and the country has been going kind of crazy lately, and I feel that we have a lot of turmoil with racism going on right now, and this racism was created by other people. Like I said, I'm going to be careful here what I say. Up until this point, I didn't think we had a racist country, but politically it's being instilled that we do, and then it's causing a lot of unrest. And it's got to the point where fear has been instilled in the country. Because of that, and because of the sickness going on, alright, my leg was amputated March 4th of last year. Okay, so I spent, and this is about the time that things were starting with the sickness, and I spent time at home, for the most part, alone, recovering. So, in a way, I felt the country was recovering with me, but I was really shocked when I got out to go to my doctor appointment for the first time, at everything being closed. Everything. Anytime I went to a doctor's appointment, me and my husband would go to breakfast right afterwards. We couldn't go to breakfast anywhere. There was no place open for breakfast. There was no place open to shop except for like Walmart. And that, most of the stuff were wiped off the shelf. How crazy is that? So that got pretty scary, and I still didn't have my leg. I was traveling in a wheelchair. We went to a big box store because I decided that I wanted to start making videos, and my old laptop is about 8 years old, and it's kind of slow compared to today's laptops, so I decided I needed a new laptop. We went to a big box store. We both had masks with us, but we did not put them on. When we entered the store, the lady at the front desk said in a panic, "I'm sorry, people, you must wear a mask. You must wear a mask to enter the store." So I'm trying to pull a mask out of my purse. In the meantime, she's calling security, and they escort us out of the store because we did not have a mask on. Do you know how upsetting that is? I went next door to Office Depot and purchased my laptop there. This big box store lost out the money. You know, a laptop's not cheap, and I paid cash for it, so. But because of that, we will never enter this big box store again. And if you live in the city I live in, you basically know what store I'm talking about. We have had incidents where we've walked into phone dealers to purchase a new phone, and they practically pushed us out. Instead of asking us to wear a mask, they just went, I might as well say, apeshit crazy, okay? So, this sickness, my husband contracted. He got really sick. He tested positive for it. I tested negative. I drank out of his Coke while he was first started showing symptoms. I drank out of his Coke outside because I was thirsty when he came home and he had a fresh Coke. Well, it wasn't so fresh. He had already opened it up and was drinking out of it. So I was tested. I tested negative. He was tested. He tested positive. And he was sick. He was really sick. For like 3 days he did nothing but sleep. I would have to wake him up to eat and take his insulin. He ran a high fever. He was sick. I, myself, had been quarantined longer than him. He had so many days after his last symptom. But because I couldn't isolate myself away from him and quarantine myself away from him since I was taking care of him, and I never wore a mask or anything around him, my quarantine time was longer, which impeded us celebrating Christmas with my daughter, son-in-law, and grandkids. That's like the first time in many, many years. And so we didn't celebrate Christmas to New Year's Day, because that's the first day that I was off of quarantine. Mind you, I tested negative the whole time. I drank from his glass. But I want to say something. I had a flu shot in the fall. He did not. So I'm wondering somehow if that flu shot protected me, or if this is a new variety of flu that I was protected because of the flu shot and he wasn't, and they made a big to-do about it. They're now talking about closing more things down. The schools here, they closed down for a week if anybody in the school tests positive. They're forcing little kids, little itty-bitty kids, 2-3 years old that are in daycare and preschool, to wear masks. How do you keep a mask on them? I just think it's all craziness. It's a tactic to put us in fear. This, where you must have the jab. All right, how many people, they don't say on the news, but you can read about it and you hear about it on other news, that die after getting the jab. How many people now are in the hospital with the sickness, excuse me, that have been fully vaccinated? How many people that have been fully vaccinated died from the sickness? I'm not going to get the jab. Number one, I don't trust it. It hasn't been around long enough to be fully tested. I think it's just another move on the people to instill more fear and have more control over us. I love the great state of Texas. Our governor is awesome. Recently, a bill was passed where I can carry my pistol with me. I have a little 380. I keep it by my side in the house because, as a handicapped person, I don't want to feel like I'm prey. I don't want to feel like a victim. I don't want to feel like a target. I'm different out there. It wouldn't take much for somebody to run up to me, shove me over, and do whatever they wanted, or kill me, or rob me. And I travel a lot by myself, so I'm alone. And I would carry it, my pistol, in the car with me and have it covered up so it couldn't be seen. But I would not take it into stores and such with me. And now I can openly just walk out my door carrying it and feel more protected, and it makes my heart feel better. Abortion. Abortion is murder. I don't care what you say. I may lose subscribers over this. I may lose relatives over this. This is my view. The same people that are out there demanding that the jab becomes mandatory. Okay, this is my body. I should decide what jab I get or not. These are people that are the same people that are stating that the jab should be mandatory are the ones out there screaming, my body. I can do with it what I want to do with it. But you got to think, your body is just a house for a human life. If you took that human life after it was born, it would be murder. So what makes it different that it's okay to take that human life after the heartbeat starts? I am, like I said, I only got like 250 subscribers. If I lose some people over this, I don't care. But it's just some stuff I had to get off my chest. And I hope I don't lose a whole lot of subscribers, but that's my viewpoint. If I can get what the subscribers still want to stay subscribed to my channel, to go ahead and hit the like button. And, you know, tell your friends. Share the video. There's so much going on right now, and it's just instill fear. And, all right, another thing I have to say is I'm disappointed. I'm disappointed that our president, it's not the official president, but our president didn't have enough power to stop this from going on to begin with. I thought he had more power. I was sure he had more power. And all I got to do is I just keep praying that everything comes to a head and that the right thing out there goes on. I am watching so many videos where they're pulling ballots and they're checking and doing recounts. And I can just keep my fingers crossed and pray that this country becomes whole again. The 13 soldiers, and soldiers I mean heroes, that were killed over across the ocean, you know where I'm talking about, and all the innocent Americans stuck over there to be probably brutally killed by what's going on over there, and our government is sitting back twiddling its thumbs saying, we're done with them. We gave them all this equipment. We're gonna let them use that against us. Oh. They can't use it against us. They don't know how to use the equipment. Why they're over there using the equipment. All right, I think that's all I'm gonna say today. When I finish putting my leg on here, I'm pretty much upset about all of this, and I hope you all have a wonderful day. My day is going to be great. It's beautiful here. We had temperatures in the 60s overnight. That's the first time in months, and right now it hasn't hit 80 yet, but unfortunately it's still going to be in the mid 90s this afternoon, so we don't know when we're going to see the end of that. I do love the heat, prefer it much more than cold weather, but that's me. Alright guys, thank you for joining me today. If you go ahead and hit the like and subscribe button, have a wonderful day. Until next time.